Hi viewers, welcome to my YouTube channel. In this video, I am posting some relevant topics which I gained from my experience, travel diaries and knowledge with divergent cultured individuals related to Hindu culture. Traditions are helped to create warm positive memories that can be recalled fondly and draw family members back to one another year after year. Let the seniors enumerate their blessings and the youth get invocated. Please go through my topic. Some of the basic routine followed by Keralites during ancient times is a biggest model one can follow ahead of one's belief or culture or religion he belongs to. Early to bed, early to rise makes a man healthy, wealthy and wise was one of the greatest principles ancient period followed. Personal, habitual and habitat hygiene was a symbol of landmark from king to beggar. Routine bath with soap or any other medical or Ayurvedic solutions were taken in a nearby pond, river or even from their home wells. Temple offerings, prayers or enchanting mantras or suktams mark the start of a day. Tulasi Tirtha is also one of a powerful immunizer. Clean and healthy veg diet was a part of their routine. No wastage of food was made, given or thrown to people and surroundings. They used to welcome their guests by the principle of Atithi Devo Bhava and with Namaste. Houses were temples, which was an example for eternal existence also. Before entering their respective houses, people used to purify themselves either by cleaning or washing or bathing after external visits. A pot of water kept by the corner of front door was a typical style of insurance. People used to clean their surroundings twice a day, followed by spraying cow dung water around their premises. Cow dung water is a very good germicide. Lighting a lamp or diya on the home page, that is Pumukham, of the house during the dusk time, that is Trisandhya hour, ideally 6:10 to 6:30 p.m., followed by combined prayers or bhajan singing, etc., which marked the presence of divinity all around. This creates a positive environment, thus removing dark shades of bad vibes from the house. When the mother and newborn baby returns home after delivery, traditionally they will not be expected to venture out during the 16 days following the birth or allow other even family members to touch them. Traditionally, a Hindu woman will not let a visitor into her home during this period. During the time following the delivery, the mother and child continue to be separated from the rest of the household. It is believed that 9 months worth of menstrual blood is discharged at the time of birth, and therefore the mother and child must regain their physical health before they return to their household. So taking a time gap on getting into their family and society deeds. In case of monthly periods or menstruation cycle for women, it was advised to keep them isolated from doing heavy household activities as they will be physically weak during those days. Hindu funeral rites take the form of chants or mantras, which are specially written to be chanted at funerals. The officiate is a Hindu priest who also presides over all the Hindu funeral rites, leading the family and other mourners in the various Hindu death rituals. At the cremation, however, it is typically the eldest son who presides, with the priest overseeing the activities, though different Hindu groups may follow different Hindu funeral rites. Traditionally, the cremation ceremony involves a ritual burning of the body, attended to by a Hindu priest and male family members. Sometimes guests attended the ceremony too. The last food is offered and the cremation takes place with flowers arranged around the body. Cremation is chosen because Hindus believe that cremation is the fastest way to aid the soul in escaping the body. Cremation rituals vary from place to place, but they often include prayers and singing. Rice balls are placed around the body. Flowers may also be placed around the body. A lamb is placed near the head of the body, and water is sprinkled on the body. Food is offered. Traditionally, Hindus prefer to have their ashes spread on the waters of the Ganges River in India. Many today take the ashes to a place closer to home. There is a 60-day period after the death, during which the immediate family follows Hindu mourning customs. To regain their positivity, they refrain from visiting the family shrine and are prohibited from entering a temple or any other sacred place. This is because they are considered to be spiritually impure during this mourning period. After the Shraddha ceremony, the family typically returns to work in anywhere from 1 to 3 weeks, depending on personal preferences. Maharshis or saints explain the concept of Krimi Prakarana in Atharva Veda as there are visible or invisible minute organisms that affect on living and non-living things of biosphere. This was the basic idea for evergreen medical myths like Ashtanga Hridayam and Shushruta Samhita. The Krimi is a broad term which includes all type of worms and microbes that may be pathogenic or non-pathogenic. All Acharyas described Krimi with classification, symptoms and treatment. Infectious diseases are mentioned in Samhita Granthas as Bhuta Vishakaja, Shankaramaga and Upasargaja Rogas. Vedas or mantras were created for entire world. Puranas or holy books contains ways to ensure the art of happiness in the universe. Today youth are highly influenced by the Western culture, and they completely refuse or partially follow these traditions has become a problematic question without specific answers. Traditions represent a critical piece of our culture. They help form the structure and foundation of our families and our society. They remind us that we are part of a history that defines our past, shapes who we are today and who we are likely to become. Once we ignore the meaning of our traditions, we are in danger of damaging the underpinning of our identity. Let the youth follow the Indian traditions and beliefs and get appreciated by the world. Praying to get all people live well. Lokaha samastaha sukhino bhavantu. Om Shanti, Om Shanti, Om Shantihi.